Usapan natin ngayon yung school site titling, specifically on school site special patent. Kaibigan, isang mahalagang topic ang ating pag-uusapan. Ito ay tungkol sa school site acquisition, school site titling and acquisition. So paano nga ba mapatituluhan ng isang paaralan yung lupa na kinakatayuan ng school? Paano magkakaroon ng titulo? Maaring kayo ay mag-apply ng special patent na pag-aaralan natin sa video na ito. Kaya maaari kayong mag-apply ng transfer certificate of title o kaya special land use permit or gratuitous special use permit. Ang special patent, mga kaibigan, ay ini-issue yan sa mga school site o lupain na hindi pa naka-issue sa isang private individual. Wala pang certificate of title or original certificate of title or transfer certificate of title issued to the private individual. So pag wala pang certificate of title, ibig sabihin yan that is owned by the government. So the government has the right to issue a special patent to convey, to cede, and to grant full ownership to the Department of Education that the parcel of land will be used for education purpose. Then, halimbawa naman, mayroong private individual na nag-donate sa school site. Mayroon siyang certificate of title. Transfer certificate of title covers 10 hectares. Gusto niya i-donate yung 1 hectare to the school, which is the minimum area in a school, as a school site. Now, para mahiwalay yung 1 hectare na donated land from the 10 hectare covered by certificate of title, kayo po ay magpapasurvey. Magpapasurvey, resurvey para ma-define yung meets and bounds ng 1 hectare. Ang gagawin nyo, hindi po magpa-process. Iba ang process sa special patent. Iba ang gagawin nyo pag ang lupa ay mayroon ng certificate of title issued to the private individual. Ang gagawin nyo, pupunta kayo ngayon sa Register of Deeds. Iba ang process how to transfer a certificate of title from a private individual to the school. Sa special patent po, pupunta tayo sa SENRO. Sa SENRO ng Department of Environment and Natural Resources. Pag timberland ang inyong lupa, iba din ang process dyan. Kayo ay mag-a-apply ng special land use permit or gratuitous special use permit para ma-grant sa inyo gamit ng lupa. So, let us define what is a special patent. Special patent is a patent issued to grant seed and convey in full ownership alienable and disposable lands of the government upon promulgation of special law or an act of Congress or a proclamation by the President of the Republic authorizing the Secretary of Education, the Secretary of Environment and Natural Resources to issue such patent. So, according to special patent is issued to grant, seed and convey full ownership. So mga cover ng special patent, mga kapwa ko guro at ating mga school head ay ang mga lupa na wala pang pribadong nagmamay-ari. Under the Regalian Doctrine, mga kaibigan, ang Regalian Doctrine nagsasaad na lahat ng lupa sa Pilipinas, it is presumed that is owned by the government except those that are already titled by the private individual. So, kung ang isang lupa ay wala pang Certificate of Title, Original Certificate of Title, and Transfer Certificate of Title, kung wala pa siyang titulo sa isang private individual, meron lang tax declaration, ibig sabihin yan, pagmamay-ari pa yan ng government. It's not yet titled by a private individual. So ang gobyerno lamang ang may karapatan to issue, grant, permit to use, to cede, and to transfer full ownership to the school. Ang isang school ay nakatayo sa isang lupain. At nalaman ng mga teachers at school head ng school ay mayroon lang tax declaration na nakapangalan na sa school. So madali na lang po ang process na yan. Panoorin nyo po ang video na ito para malaman po natin kung ano yung mga steps na gagawin para makuha natin yung special patent na ma-issue sa ating school. Mayroon lima pagkakataon, mga kaibigan, na yung donor ng lupa ay mayroon lang tax declaration. Hindi pa talaga na-issue sa kanila, hindi pa talaga na-issue sa kanilang pangalan ang titulo o yung Certificate of Title and Transfer Certificate of Title. Kung magkaganon, mga kaibigan, wala pang titulo ang isang pribadong individual, nakapangalan sa kanya ang tax declaration pero wala pang titulo, ibig sabihin niyan pagmamay-ari pa rin ng gobyerno ang lupa. So maari nating i-apply yan for special patent. Mga kaibigan, na yung donor ay mayroong ng Certificate of Title or Transfer Certificate of Title. Sa ganung pagkakataon, hindi na po tayo sa ganung pagkakataon, iba po ang proseso ng pagsisiparit ng title. Hindi po siya special patent. Ang a-apply po natin ay Transfer Certificate of Title from another title, from Original Certificate of Title, or maybe from another Transfer Certificate of Title. Halimbawa naman, upon discovery, ang inyong school site is a timberland. Mayroon pong ibang proseso din na maaari nating gamitin para makakuha tayo ng ownership document doon din sa DENR. Balikan natin, mga kaguro at kaempleyado, lalo na sa ating mga school head, ang special patent. Once a special patent shall only be issued to alienable and disposable land. So paano natin masasabi na ang isang lupa ay alienable and disposable land? According to our law, generally, those that are alienable and disposable land are the agricultural land. Pero kung hindi natin alam kung alienable or disposable ang ating school site, ang kinakatayuan, ang lupang kinakatayuan ng ating school site, maaari tayong pumunta sa pinakamalapit na Senro office sa ating lugar. To whom the special patent for public school site will be issued? The school site special patent shall be issued under the name of the Republic of the Philippines Department of Education and the name of the school as indicated in the judicial form. So hindi po siya ipapangalan sa school head, hindi rin sa teacher, o hindi rin doon sa donor ng lupa, kundi ipapangalan siya sa Department of Education with the specific name of the school. So ang ownership po dyan is under the name of the Department of Education. Kaya nga, mga kaguro at kapwa school head, wala pong authority ang sino mang school head o teacher na mag-waive o mag-enter into contract in relation to the school site because the properties is owned by the Department of Education. So only the Secretary of Education has the authority to accept, to buy, and to sell a real property specifically in relation to the school site. Now, who may request for the issuance of a special patent? Who is the person authorized to request for the issuance of the special patent? It is the school's division superintendent or any authorized representative of DepEd central office may use or may request for the issuance of the special patent. Ano ba yung mga requirements natin para ma-issue yung special patent? Una is the request from the school's division superintendent. Then you also need the historical background of the position or occupation of the land. Then a recent photograph showing a panoramic view of the area as well as the adjacent area, vicinity of the improvement, introduce the building, landmark, identifying features, settlement if any. And the certification of no pending land registration over the proposed area issued by the regional trial court or the land registration authority having the jurisdiction of the said land. Now, if you have all those requirements on the part of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources, dapat meron silang copy of the cadastral map or survey plan of the land that is duly approved by the DNR regional office. Then copy of the technical description of the parcel of land subject of the application and certification that the land is alienable and disposable. Now, what are procedure as to the processing of request for a special patent? The request for the issuance of a special patent for public school shall be filed in the SINRO or the implementing PENDRO that exercise jurisdiction over the area of the parcel of land where the request is requested. So kung sino po ang nakasakop na SINRO sa lupain ninyo, doon tayo mag-a-apply. So in the case of Northern Samar, mayroon tayong dalawang SINRO. In the first district, nandyan ang opisina nila sa University of Western Philippines, Catarman. At yung second district, ang opisina nila ay nasa Pambuhan, Northern Samar. So all schools within second district, ang pag-apply for a special patent is in Pambuhan. And for the first district, it is covered by Catarman University of Western Philippines. Now, ano ang gagawin sa SINRO office? The request for the special patent shall be accompanied with the requirements mentioned. Then, upon the receipt of the request, the SINRO shall cause the posting or notices within 15 days in the municipality or in the city hall or in the barangay and in the public school premises. The SINRO shall issue the certificate of posting or notice after 15-day period has elapsed. So what is the purpose of the posting of notice? So that everybody will know or the whole world will know that there is a request for the issuance of the special patent. Baka mayroong mga tao na nagpo-protesta o mayroong ibang individual na may hawak pala ng titulo ng nasabing lupa na subject of the application of the school for special patent. So yun po yung purpose. Then in case of an opposition is filed, the 120-day period for processing shall be deemed uninterrupted. So only based on certificate of title duly issued to the oppositor over the same parcel of land shall be given a due course. So ibig sabihin, yung entertain lang ng SINRO ay yung mga tao or individual na mayroong certificate of title, original certificate of title at transfer certificate of title na hawak-hawak nila over the same parcel of land. Ibig sabihin, Kung ikaw ay may-ari ng lupa, ang hawak mo ay tax declaration, wala kang certificate of title, you will not be entertained by Sendro. Your opposition over the request for application for the parcel of land will not be entertained by the Sendro. Then the Sendro shall fast track the resolution of all opposition arising from special patent request through the use of alternative dispute mode of resolution. So kung halimbawa naman mayroong valid claim, mayroong certificate of title, transfer certificate of title, yung individual na nag-file ng protest over the application of the parcel of land for school titling, then the Sendro will have the fast track resolution of the opposition within 30 days and shall resolve and make a recommendation within 30 days from filing of such opposition. So hindi po patatagalin ng Sendro yung pag-resolve ng opposition. Halimbawa man po, valid ang claim at opposition, mayroon na ngang na-issue na certificate of title doon sa valid claimant or individual, the request for special patent for a school site will be disapproved. Pero kung napag-alaman na hindi naman valid ang claim, itutuloy ang application or request hanggang sa approval ng said special patent or request. The next process is upon approval by the Sendro, the request shall be completely transferred or transmitted to the Pendro for the approval. And the Sendro shall include all the records in the special patent in the land. Sendro has or shall have a 5 days from the receipt of the transmittal of the Sendro to approve or disapprove the special patent request. So mayroon pa rin kapangyarihan ang Pendro whether to approve or disapprove. Kahit na-approve na yan ng Sendro, if it is submitted to the Pendro, mayroon pa rin silang power to approve or disapprove the application. Then, the Section 7 of these guidelines, mayroon special numbering assigned for every special patent approved or signed by the Department of Environment and Natural Resources. So, in summary, mga kaguro at mga schoolhead, here are the list of requirements for a special patent. The request form, you have the historical background of the position or occupation, the recent photograph showing the panoramic view of the school, the court certification of no pending land registration, the notice of request, the certificate of posting, the ocular investigation report, cadastral map or survey, the technical description, the transmittal from Sendro to Pendro, the judicial form, and the issuance of the special patent. So, nandyan po yung flow chart of the processing and issuance of special patent for a school site. So, ito po yung mag-i-explain ng mga proseso kung hindi nyo naintindihan yung ating explanation kanina. So, ayon sa ating chart, from filing from the Sendro or the implementing Pendro, pagkatapos niyan, there will be a posting of notice by the Sendro for 15 days. After posting is the issuance of certificate of posting by the Sendro. Then, it starts now the processing and publication. If there is an opposition, the Sendro will conduct alternative dispute resolution within 30 days, EDR. Pag mayroong valid claim, i-deny ang request. Pero pag walang valid claim, i-approve ang request. Then, the documents, records will be submitted for the Pendro for approval. Within 5 days, the Pendro shall act on the request whether to approve or disapprove the request for a special patent. So ayan po mga kaibigan, pinapakita natin dito yung sample ng original certificate of title special patent ng school. Yan po ang ganyan po ang i-issue na special patent para po sa ating school. Lamang po mga kaguro, kaibigan at empleyado, maraming salamat po sa inyong pagtutok. Kung mayroon kayong tanong, bisitahin nyo kami sa aming Facebook page at Attorney Restricti Adarain. Magandang araw!